Sweater guys, been here many times before. Young lady was sitting in lesbian row, has a broken toe, wanted to talk about it on television. Guy just showed up. Don't know who he is. Who are you, sir?
I'm Chaz.
Oh, Chaz. Oh, I feel so much better. Now, Chaz, when I brought these other people down to the show, to be on the show, you decided to come down too. Why?
I also am a sweater guy.
He's with you?
No.
Do you know who the sweater guys are?
I don't know any of these people.
Right. All right, well, look, it's a... where are you from?
I'm from Chantilly, Virginia.
I didn't understand any of that.
Chantilly, Virginia.
Chantilly, Virginia?
Yeah.
Are you here in vacation?
Vacation.
And you hurt your toe?
And I hurt my toe.
And I almost stepped on it.
Jay Chaz, look, you just let it go, all right? Who's Chaz? See, we've heightened security since the anthrax threat, so now people can just wander up to the stage. If you feel like you want to be on television, I'm not trying to put anything together. Come here and help your
Crikey.
Self, apparently. Now, we're worried about you because you've got a sore toe, you broke it on a sprinkler.
Well, yeah, but I was waiting in line for your show.
Do I detect a threatening of a lawsuit?
I still came.
You know, thanks. And we've got a present for you. Hang on. Here. You want that. You want that because we don't know where Chaz and the sweater guys have been, and they may try and hug you. And you won't be able to run because your foot is injured.
It's going to be a pretty rough show tonight, everyone.
Wait a minute, we've cut out one of the sweater guys. Two of the sweater guys if you don't have the high-def television. Let's everybody bunch up a little bit. Everybody, you go down at the front, and then sweater guy, Chaz, you go there, because I want to know where you are. And everybody else. And I'll go and stand off here with the skeleton robot.
With Craig Ferguson, sponsored by Expedia, where you book matters. Ladies and gentlemen, Craig Ferguson.
Hey, everybody! Try and be a little quieter. You're beginning to harsh my anthrax buzz. poisony. Very attractive studio audience this evening. I'm very excited about tonight's lesbian row. Sneak a look. Go on. I like like it when the girls make an effort, do you know what I mean? And also when they wear something nice. I don't know what all this is. I don't know. Anyway, it's a great day for America, everybody. Yes, a great day for America. And a great day for a hero of mine, Sean Connery, who is 81 today. Happy birthday, Big Tam. 81 years ago today, God looked around and said, what am I going to do with all this chest hair? And he... Thanks for the hair, God. You could have put some up here, though. There's too much hair. And yeah, gosh. You all right? Why are you wearing a sling? Your arm broken again?
Yeah.
The hell?
I got in an accident.
Kind of accident?
That's code, by the way.
For what?
I was masturbating. Ah.
So you got in a masturbation accident?
That's right. I was in a terrible masturbation accident.
Well, you know, you gotta learn to pace yourself. You gotta know when to hold them and know when to fold them.
I just didn't know when to walk away. Because I can't.
Yeah. All right, enough, all right? All right, shh, quiet. I'm doing the thing.
Go on.
All right. Did you watch the Today Show today?
Yes.
I watched the Today Show. I know it's on NBC, but I watch it anyway because I don't give a... And they had a 75-year-old woman on. Not Kathy Lee or Hoda. A different 75. It's a joke. No, they had a 75-year-old woman on who had double D breast implants. And I'm thinking, good for you, girlfriend. Good for you. Not only do you look sexy and feel vibrant, but they could save your life. You'd be, I've fallen and I've bounced back up. Dick Cheney has a book coming out. He said that when people in Washington read it, heads will be exploding. That's what he said. And people are really nervous because when Cheney says heads will be exploding, heads will be exploding. You know, the name of Katie Couric's new daytime talk show has been announced. To make sure it has great ratings, they're calling it Oprah. Now... You watching what's going on in Libya? It's frightening, isn't it?
No, it's terrifying.
No, and everyone's still looking for that nut job. Not just in Libya, am I right? For Muammar Gaddafi. He's still at large. The rebels who ransacked his compound today made an interesting discovery, though. I'm not making this up. Gaddafi apparently had an obsession with former Secretary of State Condoleezza Rice. He even had a scrapbook full of her pictures. It's true. And not a lot of people are surprised by this, but I'm not. You see, because I'm attracted to powerful women. Condoleezza Rice, Madeleine Albright, Ryan Seacrest, all of them. That's like a late night joke there, right there.
Oh man, move over, Ghost Rider. Yeah. You're on fire.
Ghost Rider?
Yeah.
The new one's coming out, the Ghost Rider.
Very excited.
I'm very excited too. Do you want to go with me?
Yeah, because you know me, I love a good flaming skull.
Is that code?
Oh yeah.
Yeah. Anyway, our thoughts, of course, are with everyone on the East Coast who are preparing for the arrival of Hurricane Irene. In Washington, D.C., thousands have been left with no power. They're called Democrats. They're battening down the hatches in New York. The experts are saying this could be the biggest disaster in New York since Spider-Man the Musical. No, this hurricane's not a joke. No, it's already a Category 3. It's named Irene. Now, back in the 50s and 60s, all the hurricanes had female names, but not today. They alternate today between a man and a woman, then a man, then a woman, then a man, then a woman. Remind you of anyone? Now, if you don't know about hurricanes, they start out as tropical depressions. You know, that's a meteorological term. A bunch of clouds get together and they're like, oh. Then they start spinning around and gorging themselves on moist tropical air. And before you know it, the local weatherman has a huge boner yelling, everybody, kiss their ass goodbye! That's the technical description of a hurricane right there. But the big storms like this, it's a change from where I grew up. Weather in Scotland is crap, but it's gentle crap. You don't have mega storms. You don't, it doesn't go, wah! It's just constantly moist. By the way, Constantly Moist is the name of my Pink Floyd tribute band. And my new feminine hygiene project. Too much, you think?
I'm looking at you, lesbian rose.
Hey! Anyway, in the next 24 hours, the Carolinas are expecting 6 to 10 inches, and they're expecting rain. And the National... See what I did? Yeah! You and me are the only people that are enjoying this tonight, Jeff.
You got that right.
I'm worried about your arm.
Yeah, me too. Now neither one of them works.
How are you going to pass the time?
I don't know, man. I'm just going to stand here and do nothing.
Remind you of anyone? I turned the tables on him!
You're a genius.
I'd like to think so, but yet not.
So, what do you want to do now?
I don't know. Well, at least we're not on the East Coast. They're in real trouble over there, though. It's awful, that thing. The National Weather Service are saying that if it's going to rain. And it could be twice as bad if Gerard Depardieu's in the area. Then it would get even... see? That's right, we remember, you incontinent French bastard.
Wow, you're working dark again.
Am I? It was just a joke, really. I mean, he did get on an airplane and say, I have to go for a pee, and then went for a pee.
Well, I admire that. You know, Gerard's a good friend.
Really? I didn't know
Gerard. Yeah, yeah.
Really? No, how do you know Gerard Depardieu?
Well, I met him once while we were urinating in a public place.
Which public place was that?
It was somewhere south of France.
South of France? You mean Spain?
Sure, that's
you were in Spain? So you were in Spain with Gerard Depardieu just peeing wherever you want?
Yes, we
were. Now, how could you hold, pee if both your arms were broken?
Oh, hell.
Depardieu helped you?
Oh, he helped me all right.
You know, we better, do the thing.
Oh, all right.
All right.
Tonight's episode of The Late Late Show with Craig Ferguson is brought to you by Constantly Moist.
The fans of this show are so dedicated that if they injure their small, tiny little pinky toe, they still show up. Take that, Glee. How you doing, Jeff? How's the arm feeling?
I'm all right, pal.
Yeah. Right.
I broke my arm, lady.
Yeah, he broke his arm.
And I'm here every friggin' night.
Calm down, man. We're meant to do improv. Do improv.
Oh, yes, and...
There you are. You see, that's how you do the improv, isn't it, Jeff?
Yes, and I agree, Craig.
Take that, Drew Carey's improv thing.
Yes, and...
Can you do the whatchamacallit, the Tweety, the intro?
Yes, and...
Yeah.
Gather around the TV, folks. It's tweet mail time. Time for Uncle Craig to reach in the old mail sack and scratch the tweets.
Yeah! This is from Sandy in Des Moines, in Iowa. It's completely... Are you all from Des Moines? Holy crap, who's left in Des Moines? That's over 12 people in the audience from Des Moines. I'm kidding, people in Des Moines. Please don't send me any anthrax. All right, this is from Sandy in Des Moines, Iowa, who says, hey, Craig, I've developed a crush on a man who's openly gay. What does that say about me? It says you're a dude and you're openly gay. Unless you're a lady, and if you've developed a crush on a man who's openly gay, then perhaps you have a fear of intimacy. Or you like men who are clean.
Yes, and...
I really wish you would stop improvising now. It's putting me off.
Yes, and I once was in love with a horse.
No. No awing. They tell them out of the door. You awe when you come in here, we break your toe. That's the first thing I have. That's the first thing. Yeah. Yeah! They broke my toe! People are crazy. This is from Honor in Billings, Montana. All right, I think I've spotted your technique. Honor says, dear Craig, I'm in yoga instructor training, and I've heard that you say that you practice. Any chance you can show me and the other instructors your downward facing dog? No, I can't. I've thrown my back out. Jeff will do it though. Well, yeah, go on, you go. Give it a bit of yoga down the front. Come on.
I can't.
Come on. Do your tree pose.
All right. Breathe in slowly. Turn your head this way. Oh, hell, I can't do it.
I know. It's pretty good. I felt quite sort of... Yes, and I enjoyed it. All right. This is from Brandon in Mount Vernon, Illinois. It says, dear Craig, Jeff, and Secretary! Secretariat nearly, the back end of Secretariat fishtailed right out there. There was nearly an incident that could have, somebody's toe could have got broken here. Brandon says, dear Craig, Jeff, Secretariat, my mother tells me I'm an idiot for getting tattoos. What are your thoughts on the matter? Yes, you are. Let me just say to you. Don't ever get a tattoo here, by the way. You know most people that get tattoos, they get sleeve tattoos and it stops about there? And you see how this little part of this tattoo goes on a little bit further? Goes up in there? There's a reason why most people don't do that. It's really fucking sore. And I didn't know it was going to be sore. And then in the tattoo parlor, when all the other tattoo artists get round and they see where you're going to get the tattoo, so they all take a seat and watch you. That's when you know it's going to hurt. Do you have any tattoos, Jeff?
Yes. And I have one on my sternum.
Do the commercials.
We'll be right back with more Late Late Show with Craig Ferguson, now with Wings.
Has just finished working for 2 years for the Obama administration, and it will soon be on CBS's How I Met Your Mother. So he's going up in the world then. Please welcome Kal Penn, everybody. Kal Penn. Hey, Kal.
How are you?
I'm good. I don't think think I've seen you since before the election.
No, no, it's been like 2 or 3 years.
Yeah, you were here, you were helping Obama win the election, you and Obama won the election, then he gave the job to Biden, that must have been a little awkward. And then you went to work for him for 2 years?
Yeah, it was great. Moved to D.C. for a couple of years and then wanted to do 2 years and then come back. So.
Right, so you're back now, you're so back in show business at a proper job. You know what? Did you just get back?
I just got back.
Were you there for the earthquake?
I was.
Really?
Yeah, so we traded because you got anthrax and we got the earthquake.
Right, that's true, yeah. Do you get a lot of that in the White House, a lot of scary letters?
Earthquakes or other?
No, earthquakes, no.
You know, they read all the mail kind of before it gets to us.
Oh, you mean like they have some kind of security system?
Right. Should look into it. And we have, you know, we have gas masks and everything, and you had to buy them after the fact. But you know,
you have to buy your own gas.
No, not. I mean, there's budget cuts, but not that bad.
So if you go in, say I go to work in Washington, right, and I say, oh, right, I'll work here, and they say, well, there's your gas mask. This was Kal Penn's gas mask before.
I don't know that they recycle them.
Well, I don't know. A pretty expensive gas mask.
Where'd you get yours?
I don't have one.
You don't?
No.
I
just inhale the anthrax and hope for the best, man. No, so you're back now. You're back in show business.
Great. To be back.
Good for you. And welcome back to Latte.
Thank you.
So what you got? CBS? That's your first choice back?
Yeah. Hell, man. I mean, you know, I wanted to. No.
Yeah, no, it's great. They're a great company, really valuable.
I love the show. I love.
Yeah.
I love
that's a good show. That is a good show. No, they have lots of good shows. It's just this isn't one of them. But they have a lot of. They do have a lot of good shows. So you lived in D.C., but now you're. But did you rent out your house, or what did you do?
Yeah. So I was renting out my place. Had a couple buddies living there. They took care of the place.
Did they smoke marijuana and burn your carpets?
No. I have hardwood.
They did. I can tell when you're lying.
No.
And then you moved your hand like that, like yes.
This one?
Yeah, that was the tell.
I move it.
Do you play poker?
I don't.
And you shouldn't start. Because it sounded to me like your house got trashed.
No.
Do you have a dog?
I don't, but I want to get one. I want to adopt a brown lab.
Why a brown lab?
Because they're brown like me. I don't know. They just kind of. I remember, here, I'll tell you the true story. When I was a kid, I remember watching an episode of Different Strokes.
Right.
And Arnold was getting a dog.
Yes.
And the dog,
I think we all learned a lot from Different Strokes, really.
And it was a black dog, and he said, he's black, like me. And that was the first time I think I actually had, like, a consciousness about that. And then everybody always says, your dog's supposed to look like you and all that. So it's a really
I've got three different dogs.
What do you have?
I have a German dog, a French dog, and an Irish dog. They're all white, though. They're not all white. The German dog is black, but come on, he's German. So he's not actually black. He's wearing black. I'm sure I get into a lot of trouble right there when I did that, but... So you're out of politics completely then, that's it?
I think so. I wanted to do about 2 years. I'd like to work on the president's re-election and balance that with some creative stuff.
Are you gonna go back and help with the campaign then?
Yeah, I hope so.
Oh, okay.
I hope so.
Right, so it's got to be a little trickier in the re-election campaign.
It's a little different, different than it.
Yeah, because, you know, before you do the job, everyone's like, oh, he'll be great at it. And then you do it for a couple of years and everybody goes, hey, where's the money? Where is the
Cracking.
Money, Kal? Where's the money?
It's a tough fiscal climate.
Try saying that in a bar.
Well, that's
you go to a bar and say, I'd like a beer and a shot. And they go, okay, give me the money. You go, it's a tough fiscal climate.
I think that's been the hardest thing to kind of, you know, when I was working in that job to kind of see, you know, the argument that we are, you know, the president kind of saved us from a second Great Depression, right? A huge economic collapse. But things are still not good enough. So
right.
The fact that they could have been worse is not always something that people can kind of rally around. So it's going to take a little longer, I think.
You know, I'd be careful, man. You're starting to talk a little like a politician.
You think so?
Yeah, a little bit. I think you have to get back here and say, I want to get a brown dog. That's the Kal Penn I know.
I want a brown dog.
I want a brown dog.
Large coffee.
Yeah, and a big cup.
Want to go hiking.
Yeah. Are you going to do all that? Then you get back into it? You stayed in shape when you were in Washington.
Are you kidding? No.
What?
No, you got to, the difference between a desk job, I think I realized this when you know, I would kind of walk. I was only about a mile from work, but you're sitting at a desk all day.
Oh, you tell me about it,
right?
Yeah.
I gotta go back to the gym.
Really?
Oh yeah.
Oh okay.
Yeah.
Well,
I mean, you know, just feel better. I did the hand thing.
Is that, you were doing that. But I thought that's a different thing. That's kind of code in some way. You know, I'm starting to feel better. All right.
I'm a righty, but.
What do you do? You go to the gym then? You don't hike up and down? You don't paraglide? That's popular with the celebrities. I just made that up. Yeah, I made it up. Yeah. Gwyneth Paltrow paraglides all the
Tootsie Fruits.
She's all like, hello, I'm Gwyneth Paltrow.
I was so hoping you had evidence that you were going to cite all these celebrities. That
Gwyneth Paltrow likes to paraglide. Everybody knows that. Yeah. And of course, David Hasselhoff. And many other celebrities.
I have a 2-year gap in my pop culture knowledge, right?
Right.
Because I was just not here.
You never heard?
Nothing.
All right. So you gotta I'll fill you in very briefly. Jersey Shore, had that started?
I watched Jerseylicious rather than Jersey Shore.
What's that?
It's similar in terms of following people from New Jersey, but it's women that grew up in Central Jersey, right around kind of where I grew up.
I see.
Yeah.
And when we're talking about you watched women from your old neighborhood, are we talking a private camera that you watched them on?
I don't... What?
Yeah. No. I see. All right.
Mm. Okay, so Jersey Shore. What else?
Right. Andy Dick sobered up and he's doing great.
Okay. Okay.
And I think that's... Nothing else really happened. There was a couple of things with Charlie Sheen. Nothing much. And that's about it, really. Nothing else. No, you didn't miss much. I don't think. Anything else happened? Oh, we got a robot as well.
Hey.
What's up, Jeff?
How you doing, man?
Good, man. How are you?
Good. You're looking great.
Thank you. You too.
He did that with his hand when he's lying, Jeff. He said, you too, and he went...
Yeah,
he did that. Oh, we're out of time, Cal. we want a mouth organ, awkward pause, or touch my glittery ball?
Awkward pause.
Oh, okay. Okay. 2 years, and you want to go straight for the awkward pause?
Awkward pause.
Okay. I'm gonna get back on the acting horse right away.
Is there finger smelling or just awkward
pause? No, it's not the finger smelling. What we're doing now, the new awkward pause is, it's awkward because I'm trying to sneak looks at your genitals.
Okay.
All right. Show where one of the ladies has a broken toe, Jeff has a broken arm, and I have a broken heart. I can't tell you why. But Jeff can.
No, I can't.
You're meant to say yes and...
No.
And then improvise.
Yes, and I
can't.
I'm responsible.
You've said too much. My first guest has left. My second guest is a guest starring on the Entourage show, which is very good. It's on Sundays on HBO. Take a look at this. That's like a scene from my life. Please welcome the spectacular Alice Eve, everybody. Alice Eve. Lovely. Look at you with your lovely dress.
Thank you.
That's
very
a very nice piece of clothing.
Thank you.
You have there. How are you? You good?
Very well, thank
you. Good. I saw you on The Entourage. I watched that show.
Did you? The Entourage?
Yes, I watched The Entourage with all these lovely...
The boys.
Yes, they're all quite small. You can't comment on that,
no.
But I've noticed that they are. Yes. Whenever they're all together, I want to just, give them
Cuddle
a hug.
Them.
Yeah, they
are lovely.
But you're playing someone who's very tough and...
I know, I hadn't seen that actually. It's a little...
Are you not aware of what you're doing while you're acting?
No.
That's what makes you so good.
You jump and then you kind of come to the surface, but I hadn't seen it. It's always weird watching yourself.
You don't watch yourself on TV?
No, I don't like to. Sometimes you have to correct it and to know what you're doing. But it's not nice. Do you like watching yourself?
No, I don't watch this crap. No. I've got cable. I don't watch this.
Ooh la la!
I'm kidding. I don't have cable. You're living here now, then? You've made your home in Los Angeles?
Yes, I still have my family in London, but yes, I right. do. I mean, yeah.
By your family, you mean, four or five children working up chimneys?
My two husbands.
Two husbands?
Yeah. That's polygamy, I believe in it, much like Gaddafi.
Oh, no, it's all right. You can say anything you like about Gaddafi.
Yeah. Where did he go?
I don't know. I think he's probably... If I was Condoleezza Rice, though, I'd be checking under the car and stuff until...
Yeah, that was a weird fact.
Yeah, that's a weird
that's
one,
weird.
Isn't it?
That's yeah. weird, yeah, if that's true.
Do you have any weird stalker fans who are also dictators of African countries?
No.
Do you have any weird stalker fans?
I hope not, no.
Anybody ever sent you some anthrax, for example?
No, that's heavy. But I hear you snorted it.
I did, yeah. Yeah.
How was that for you?
Yeah, it wasn't that good.
Like the old days?
No. In the old days, I had no idea what it was when right. I was snorting it. I knew what it was then. You've never been involved in heavy drug use, have you?
Never.
Oh, dear.
I had parents, too.
I just didn't invite them to the club, that's all.
I did.
Oh, you did?
Well, sometimes my mum goes out with me, yeah.
I've met your mum and your dad.
Yeah.
Yeah, I met them actually back in the day. Because I used to go to this club, and they used to come in sometimes. I used to eat at this restaurant in London, and your mum was a friend of my friend, Anthony Head.
Oh, yes, of course.
Right. And so but you must have been like 10 years old then.
Yeah.
They would never bring you to a club at that point.
No, not a club, a restaurant.
Really?
Yeah, I used to sleep in the restaurant.
Really? You would go to restaurants as a child?
Yeah.
Must be all right for some. I mean, the first time I went to a restaurant, I was 16.
Really?
Yeah.
McDonald's?
They were the neighboring clan, yes. No. So your family back then, but you've decided to move. Do you have a dog yet?
No.
You should get a brown lab. That's all the celebrities.
So you did your German thing again tonight.
What German thing?
Don't let's be beastly to the Germans.
Yes, I know. We mustn't be beastly to the Germans. Who was that? It was Noel Coward, wasn't it?
It was. And last time we said it was Monty Python, but it was actually...
No, it was Noel Coward, yeah, who sang that song, Let's Not Be Beastly to the Germans.
Yeah.
Noel Coward also said, do you know the actor Edward Woodward?
Oh, yes, I do.
Yeah. Noel Coward said Edward Woodward's name sounded like a fart in the bath. Edward Woodward.
Edward Woodward. Yeah. It's a good expression.
It was Noel Coward! It's not me, it was Noel Coward! Do you follow the work of Noel Coward, even though he's been dead for about 20, 30, maybe 50 years?
He was brilliant.
He was, very good, yeah.
But how does one follow the work of Noel Coward?
Well, you just go back and look at all his old films,
I've done
plays
that,
and stuff. You've seen the plays, yeah? You've been in any plays, yeah?
In any of his plays?
Yeah.
No. But I have been in some plays, but not his plays.
Well, what plays have you been in then?
I was in a play called Rock and Roll.
I don't like that one.
Okay.
What's that play then, Rock and Roll?
Tom Stoppard play.
Oh, he's pretty clever, isn't he?
Yeah,
there is that, yeah. Didn't he write Shakespeare in Love?
He did,
yeah.
And he won an Oscar for it.
Oh, he did, yeah, bastard. I met him once, you know, Tom Stoppard.
Did you?
Yeah.
He's very tall, isn't he?
He is, and actually I was walking out of a house, a sort of area, and he was walking in and I held the door open for him and he said, oh, thanks.
Thank you. Because he's got that Czech accent.
I wasn't able to tell from one word.
No.
No, it was just, he said, thanks, and off he went. It could have been, he might not even have English as his first language.
He doesn't.
He really doesn't?
No.
And yet he writes these plays?
Isn't it wonderful?
Yeah, it is. Have you met Jeff? Was he here last time when you were here?
Yeah, but he wasn't as good.
Yes, and.
Yes, and.
Mama.
Yeah.
What do you mean, mama?
I mean, mama.
It's very weird, Jeff.
It's very weird.
Yeah, that's very weird, Jeff. I mean, Jeff, you're gay.
I'm not.
Pick and choose, like, well, I suppose you can,
yes,
actually.
Can.
Yeah, you can.
It's
no,
a
I feel
free country.
It is a free country. You're absolutely right. Well done, Alice, for reminding us that it's a free country. Would you ever think of joining us here and becoming an American?
I have a green card.
Well, that doesn't make you an American.
It's a complicated one, really. I love America.
Yeah, but that's all right. You don't have to. You don't have to.
No, but
I'm forcing you. You know, we're almost full up anyway. It's fine.
Okay.
You're very welcome to stay. You don't have to become an American.
Well, that's decided it.
Do that again.
Okay.
All right.
Maybe I will.
No, you don't have to. It's fine.
Okay.
I mean, you can if you want.
Yes. And?
Very good.
Yeah.
Did you ever take an improv class?
No, but I know that rule.
Well, that's the only rule I know, and apparently...
It's the only rule there is, really.
Well, yes, and?
Yeah, don't stop it.
Don't stop the flow. But you can stop the flow, and it still works.
Okay. No.
Hence the awkward pause, which is the deconstruction of the lame idea that improv can only be done with yes and. Which it can't always be done with yes and. It can sometimes be done with just a look or a gesture or a smell my finger.
Shall we prove it?
Right, I will.
Yes and?
No, we're not doing yes and. Do you want to do the awkward pause now? I mean, it is about time.
No, let's not do the awkward
pause. You don't want to do the awkward pause?
It's so awkward.
Well, what do you want to do then?
I want to feel comfortable.
Yeah, come over here then. Hey, my arms don't work, but I got a lot of spirit.
Man, I don't know. I don't think that's appropriate, Jeff. I know this young lady's parents.
Yeah. I'm terribly sorry.
Yeah, me too, actually. If you don't want to do an awkward pause, and you certainly
don't want to be an American.
You don't want to be an American.
You love America.
I know.
I live in America.
Mouth organ?
Okay.
Okay. Here you are.
Okay. I'm nervous about this because I can't do this.
Oh, I bet you can. Just how creepy am I right now, Jeff?
Terry!
Yeah. Oh, come on.
Terry!
It was a joke!
It's even more awkward than the awkward pause.
Yes! Exactly. I told you, take the awkward pause. It is actually paradoxically and ironically not
yes.
that awkward!
Okay, yes, and?
Right. Yes, and get the mouth organ and start blowing.
Watching Craig at home, you're missing half the fun. Consider this your formal invitation to laugh live in our studio audience at a taping of The Late Late Show with Craig Ferguson. Please give us a call at 323-570-0059 or visit our website at oneiota.com.
What did we learn on the show tonight, Craig?
You know what, buddy?
What's that, pal?
I'm getting too old for this.
Ay, caramba!
No, come on. I don't like to hear talk like that.
You're meant to say yes and.
You know what, Craig?
What?
I think tonight's show was a frank attempt at deconstructing the yes and method. And what a pile up.
I think this
it is.
You saying we sometimes know what we're doing?
Because we're professionals, damn it.
That's right. High five.